Okay.
Hi, Marie. Can you hear me? Okay. So I'm Atsushi Shimizu from Iwate Medical University. So, how do
you do this?
Okay, so I'm chair and professor of the Iwate Medical Division of Biomedical Information Analysis, Iwate Tohoku Medical Megabank Organization. I'm pleased to be here and honored to introduce our project and the latest letter to the attendees of this great meeting. So today I cover three topics. First one is Iwate. I want to explain about the Iwate prefecture. So the second one, I move to introduction about the Tohoku Medical Megabank Project. And at last, I talk about our latest research about inter-individual DNA methylation variation. So let's move on. This is the first topic, Iwate prefecture. Iwate prefecture is the second largest prefecture in Japan. So you know that the largest one is Hokkaido. So size of the Iwate is 7 times larger than Tokyo. And the current population in Iwate as first May 2017 is about 1.2 million, equivalent to 9% of Tokyo. And we are here in Ichigaya, Tokyo, so and we will be there next week. So Tokyo to Morioka is 2 hours by Shinkansen, by train. So this area, including the Miyagi, Morioka, Akita, and so on, so the Tohoku area, so Tohoku meaning northeast in Japanese. So I would like to introduce the famous school in Iwate. So it is one of the important topics for you. So the first famous food in Iwate is wanko soba noodle. Wanko means small balls in Japanese. So this is a picture of the competition of the wanko soba eating. So Morioka City is the mecca of the soba eating competition. So the participants try to keep eating their limitation. So the my personal record is 111 wanko soba noodle in 30 minutes. Yeah, thank you. So the best record in Iwate is 250 soba noodle in 5 minutes. So if you have a chance to visit the wanko soba noodle restaurant, please try to eat more than 100 wanko soba noodle. So if you achieve to eat one noodle, you can get a souvenir from the restaurant. So the next one is the Morioka giant noodle. So the origin of the giant noodle is China. So before World War I, a Chinese guy started to serve his soul food in Morioka. So and now the Chinese food have become a famous food in Morioka. So the next one, could you imagine the third one? So correct. So the third one is also noodle. So this noodle is Morioka cold noodle. The origin of Morioka cold noodle is Korea. 1950s, a Korean guy started to serve his soul food in Morioka, and now the Morioka cold noodle became a famous food in Morioka. So these are three great noodles in Morioka. So Morioka citizens have already achieved international collaboration with another country in Morioka. I hope we make new collaboration in Morioka next week. So I hope this collaboration is important to our field. So I will move to next topic, to the Tohoku Medical Megabank Project. So last presentation, the Dr. Katayama-san explained that this topic. So could you remember day 311? Yes. So the day the Tohoku the Great East Japan earthquake on Friday 11th, March 2011, the Tohoku earthquake and the tsunami struck the north part of Japan. It was the most powerful earthquake ever recorded to have hit Japan, and the fourth most powerful earthquake in the world since modern record keeping in the beginning of 19th century. So the, and here in Japan, and you can see this picture. So the color is the magnitude of the seismic scores. So red mean is the highest red score, as you can see here around the Sendai city. So this picture is the tsunami struck the cities, and you can see the board on the building. You can imagine the magnitude of the tsunami attack. So we lost 80,000 people, and more than 22,000 people still living in the shelter. After the year, the Japanese government decided to start to rebuild the medical institute in the Tohoku area. So Japanese government support our project, so Tohoku Medical Megabank Project, TMM. TMM was held by the Iwate Medical University and the Tohoku, Tohoku University. And AMED and MEX and the Reconstruction Agency supported our project. To make some of the term clear, so I here explain the abbreviation of the, in my presentation. So TMM means Tohoku Medical Megabank Project. So and TOMO means the Tohoku Medical Megabank Organization by Tohoku University. And IMM in the Iwate, Tohoku Medical Megabank Organization, Iwate Medical University. It's too long to explain, so I use these abbreviations in this slide. So aims of our team, the goal of TMM are merging the diverse medical healthcare with the rebuilding of medical system in this disaster area. And focusing on the disaster area of Iwate and Miyagi Prefecture is by conducting a large-scale genome cohort study and integrated biobank. We aim not only to contribute to restoration of local medical service, but also to start precision medicine. Tohoku, TMM is cohort and biobank. As you may know, cohort study at first to collect the questionnaire and the test result of the blood and some medical records from the group or the participants. So and we continue to record the personal lifestyle by using the questionnaire. So and several years ago, sometimes 10, 20 years later, some of the people had became some kind of the disease. So and we can analyze the association between the lifestyle and cause of disease. This is a technique to identify the factor which cause the disease. And genome cohort study, we use the genome information as one of the exposure. So and we compared with their phenotype and genotype and cause of disease. This is a technique to identify the factor caused by caused the disease. So and biobank aims of biobank is to collect the samples, so questionnaires, urines, blood, and sometimes they collect the, a piece of the organs. And so they distribute to the scientists. This is the aims of the biobanks. We already had to build a large scale genome cohort study and biobank. We already conducted birth cohort with three generations. The number of participants is more than 72,000 in 22,000 families. And also we already constructed the resident-based cohort, so about 84,000 participants of this study. So total, in total, 156,000 participants gathered our genome cohort study, and already we stored the biospecimens in our biobank. And TMM is also has a research center. In traditional biobanks, they distribute mainly biospecimens, but the number of biospecimens is limited. So if we distribute all of the sample, we don't have the specimens. So we decided to distribute this, not only samples, but also to share or distribute the data. So in our integrated biobank, we collected blood samples and analyzed the genome or mixed analysis and the data stored in the database. So this is Dr. Ogishima. He constructed this system database, DBTMM. So this DBTMM is already published in our website. So in DBTMM, we collected the data from the participants, so personal data or physical data or clinical data, and also collected the genome or omics data from his or her specimens. So, and these data are integrated in our database, and we can search some data from this database. So this is a sample of the DBTMM. So you can see the these of the data. So this is distribution of the kind of the blood test, and also these data are from questionnaires. Unfortunately, at this moment, so it's only available in Japanese, but Dr. Ogishima already planned to provide it in the result in near future. So we have also started to experiment with the genome and omics data. So here is the number of shared genomic data. Now we already achieved to share the number of the genome data from the next generation sequencer. So the number is 3,000, more than 3,500. And also we started to share the genomic data from the microarray. The number is more than 23,000. So, and in the future, we have already planned so that the number of NZS is more than 8,000, and also microarray will be increased 140,000. So a part of the data is already available in the database. So this is Dr. Nagasaki. He constructed this IJGBD database that is a genome browser. So you can see the genome browser, and you can find the SNVs of our participants, and the number is now limited. So, and also you can download the, it is not so easy to see, so that this is the link. So you can download 1,000, more than 1,000 genotype data from this link, and also you can download 2,000 data from this link. The last topic is the latest our study, inter-individual gene methylation variation. So inside cell, the four types of the nucleotide. One of the nucleotides is cytosine. Cytosine has two status, unmethylated and unmethylated. So this status is reversible, and these condition or status can control the DNA or gene expression. Here is how do we cause of the disease. So one is innate risk, so in genome. So someone has the mutation in this position, he or she has the G in this position. So this mutation causes the levels of expression. So he or she has the congenitally has the risk for some kind of the disease. And also omics data. For example, in the methylation, gene sequence, well, the genome sequence is not changed, but by the environmental factor, the methylation status will be changed. So in this case, the methylation causes reduced amount of the RNA molecules, and this causes acquired risk for disease. So this, I mean that this disease is multi-factor disease, for example, stroke or cancer or some mental diseases. So it is necessary to understand the effect of from the genome and omics. It's important to do precision medicine. So we decided to analyze the methylation data from the participants. So this is an explanation of the variation. In genome, so there are four characters of A, C, D, D. In this case, it is not so difficult to explain the variation. For example, from the group of the participants, 20 adults had C and D. 80% has a reference sequence, so this we can easily to indicate it. Minority frequency is 0.2, but in the case of the epigenome or DNA methylation, this DNA methylation status 0 to 100, and each participant has different number or status of the DNA methylation. So often a low methylation or a high methylation. So it is not so defined the epigenome variation. So in this slide, I introduced about the epigenome variation. So definition of the reference interval, because here the reference interval we decided. The indicator of the inter-individual DNA methylation variation, the reference interval RI for CP site was defined as difference between the 95th percentile and 5th percentile. This size of the interval means that epigenome variation we defined. So next, we collected the blood sample from the participant. We collected blood sample from 143 participants by using the cell sorter and also to collect the whole blood. So by using the cell sorter, we isolated about 103 types of cells, monocytes, CD4 cells, and the neutrophils. We conducted the whole genome sequence, all of the three types of cells, and also we conducted our sequence. And on the other hand, from the whole blood, we took our collaborator, conducted the whole genome sequence. We already collected the whole genome sequence and whole genome sequence and other sequence from the over the 100 participants of our study. So in this study, we determined. So in this study means that this is Dr. Hachiya. He is the first author of our study. So determined the three types of the epigenome variation. So the first one is the epigenome variation between CD4 T cells and monocytes. This is the cell type difference between cell type variation, cell type epigenome variation. So the second one is the epigenome variation between individuals. So from one person, so his CD4 T cells, and he had a DNA methylation status, and also the other one has different DNA status. So DNA methylation status, this is inter-individual variation. And third variation was cell-to-cell variation, but it is not so easy to determine the cell-to-cell variation if we want to be decided. Cell-to-cell variation, we have to isolate single cells. So in this study, we measure the body or the entire mass of the cells. So this inter-individual variation is our topics of this presentation, last presentation. So this is epigenome variation, inter-individual. So the reference interval distribution for the about 24 million CPG, including our studies. In gray, it is not so difficult to see here, is all CPGs in your profile. Gray. So when the purple one is from the human methylation 450, that is the name of the DNA methylation microarray. So, and the pink magenta line is reference intervals of the previous reported by blood-based even epigenome wide variation. So this is this CPG or associated with cause of disease. So we separate these reference interval size of the reference interval in 10 periods. So you can see the large interval, a large reference interval has a high odds ratio. So this means a large variation is associated with disease in blood. So, and so we next we analyze the data. So epigenome variation is we collected known epigenome marker and the target CPG in various techniques. So epigenome 450 or epic or should I say these are the techniques to identify the status of the CPG site, and we compare the techniques. This is the result of the test. So here you can see the odds ratio between the known epigenome marker and the techniques. So here is data from the monocyte of our study, and here is the CD4 T cells from our study. These score the high odds ratio. This means our techniques improved the techniques to identify the CPG site which are associated with the phenotypes. So this is the techniques, new techniques. So next slide show you the our database, integrated human DNA methylation variant database. So you can find by Google iMessage. So iMessage has data, so demographic data, sex and age, and whole genome sequence, SNV from the whole genome sequencing, and other age, standard deviation, reference interval, in approximately 20 million CPG from whole genome bisulfite sequencing and the exception data from ANSEC. So you can create this tab genome browser, so you can find the link to genome browser, and so here you can see the level of DNA methylation from three types of the cells, and also you can see the you can check the DNA expression level from this tag, and also you can find the SNB from this tag. So and you can see also DNA methylation frequency of each CPG site. You can see the monocyte CD4 T cell and neutrophils in one position of the CPG site. So you can compare the between the cell type, and also you can see the reference interval, the variation, methylation variation in one position in 100%. So, and almost all of the data can download from this site, from our website. So you can create this download link, so you can get the CD4 and the monocyte data from here, and neutrophils data will be available in this month, we promise. So the summary of this my presentation, TM project, we have constructed a large-scale genome cohort study and integrated biobank in disaster area in Japan, and we have published a part of the genomic or omics data on our website. And last topic, so I am your last research, from the analysis of inter-individual DNA methylation variation study, we established a new technique which can accelerate the genome research. So last slide, so thank you for TM participants, member of TMM, member of IMM, and special thanks to Dr. Katayama. Thank you for attention.